All right, we're back. This is the original batch that I did. This tire and this tire, I did a water test. We'll get back to that in a second. So it was about 8 gallons of Padobe poop that I put onto these first two tires. And I started packing the foam a little bit tighter, and so it didn't take as much. And with the next 8 gallons, you see I got pretty far. And the rest of this is still waiting. But I want to focus back down here onto the water test. This batch, it has a little bit more cement into it, a little bit less lime, and also started adding sand. We'll see how that does. We'll do a water test on this after a few days, several days, let it dry up. So these two tires were the same color a couple minutes ago. I poured a gallon onto this one, and most of it was just shedding off, just pour right off. Some of it soaking in. But I'm taking this spot right here. Is that in the camera? And just hitting with some water. And as you can see, it's only when I rub it do I get any type of degradation, and it just peels off a surface layer. So I've been squirting this thing for probably about 15 minutes. And every once in a while I can see a little piece release and come off. But it's doing pretty good on the water test. Down here on the bottom of the tire, you can see I picked on a spot, and I can get it to break up and come off where it's thin and doesn't have anything to stick to. But when it's layered upon itself, this stuff does really good. And this doesn't have a lot of cement in it, so I'm pretty surprised. But I guess overall I'd have to say this is not doing well in a water test. But it was never intended to do well. This is a subcoat, and it's going to get other coatings on top of it that can handle the water. So it's actually doing pretty good for what it needs to be. When I first started learning about papercrete, I mixed up a batch of cardboard and had some 2x4 forms and made up a couple of bricks just to see what they are like. And so there's nothing in here except for cardboard pulp, and it shrinks a lot when it dries. But these are actually pretty rugged. If you want something to compare it to, think of the drink holders that you get at McDonald's. They're just a paper pulp product that's been pressed into a form, kind of similar to these, and it holds your drinks just fine. So I guess what I'm trying to say here is that I was impressed with just, you know, how strong cardboard bricks were. Can't use them for building, they're not decoded or anything like that, but you know, when you start adding other components to it, I think we have something pretty special. Okay, we're looking at a section just above where I did the water test. I want to show this off a little bit, just to show the durability of this stuff. So I can get it to flake off. Here's this piece I just pulled off. If I roll it in my fingers, it will powderize. I don't like that about this. That's why I stopped putting so much lime and a little bit more sand. But check this out. You got a beater club of a hammer. There you go. I like it. It's doing pretty good.